In today's video, I'll show you top 5 mistakes to avoid while editing video. And these don'ts, I didn't get them randomly. All of them are the result of my experience and my mistakes. Number one mistake a lot of creators make is a mess in their project tab. Even if you have a small project with just a few files to work with, mixing videos, images, music and sound effects without putting them into separate folders will make your editing process so much slower, as you'll have a hard time to find the files you need. Don't be lazy, use folders for different types of files and you'll notice a significant increase in your efficiency. Number two mistake is not choosing a music track in first place. Novice editors start putting videos on the timeline, creating awesome transitions and effects, and once they're done, they're like, alright, now let's choose a music track. It doesn't work like that. If you want to create a video that has a nice pace with a particular mood in your voice, with the cuts in the right moments, you have to think about the music first. That'll make your editing process flawless and you won't have to redo anything, as you'll be already cutting your videos according to the music beat. I'm using Artlist, by the way. I'm talking about the pace and the mood of the video you're editing, we're approaching the third editing mistake, which is lack of dynamics. Listen, you may be a handsome guy or a beautiful girl and you're talking about important things, but statistically, as per one of the studies conducted by Microsoft, the human attention span has only 8 seconds, less than the goldfish has. So in order to not lose your viewers, you need to remember that every 8 seconds or less, you need to make a change to your video. It can be a music cut, zoom in, zoom out, different angle, sound or video effect, B-roll video. Do whatever suits your video concept, but if your viewers are online, remember about this 8 seconds rule, that'll increase your retention time for sure. Fourth mistake many creators keep making, rough audio cuts. No one wants to hurt their ears due to the drastic difference in sound levels. Viewers shouldn't even notice if there is a cut or change in the scene, and the easiest way to hide your rough cuts between the videos is to make audio tracks overlap. To do that, regardless of the software you use, just finish your first sound a second or two after the new sound starts. If you do it correctly, nobody will notice the cuts and your ears will be satisfied with the effects. And that leads us to the last mistake I wanted to talk about today. Avoiding shortcuts. Shortcuts may not sound practical when you start using them, however, after just 1 week, you will learn them by heart. You will do the entries automatically without even thinking, from your muscle memory. Example, here I have 2 shots, one after another. I want this cut to sound seamless. I use Premiere Pro, so first of all, I will unlink audio from the video to be able to stretch it independently, and then overlap the audio tracks. But that we've learned from the previous tip. To make this cut even more seamless, using the shortcut Ctrl-Shift-D, we're able to fade in and fade out the sounds at the beginning and at the end. Now the loudness will be increased and decreased gradually. More useful shortcuts you may find under Edit, Keyboard shortcuts, or by pressing the combination Ctrl-Alt-K. Guys, if you find these 5 tips useful, hit the like button to help me reach more people. Check out my other videos related to video content creation. I'm pretty sure you'll find a lot of useful information there. Love you guys, and see you in the next one. Cheers.